Can I make it up here? Yes. Good. Bit of a challenge, but I made it. I'll just go onto the road here. No reason not to. Hopefully I do make it there. I think I should. Liters left. I'm doing pretty good on petrol, so I'm thinking I should be fine. Of course, as I say that, it goes up to 8 litres per minute. Yeah, I'll make it. I need to avoid that hole though. Won't make it if I go down there. Why is my truck just not turning? I've tried making that bridge collapse, it just cannot work. I cannot get it to collapse. Easy made it. While I'm here, I may as well get the repair points as well. Well, repair the truck as well. There we go. I am gonna do this end first, because I need another load of logs, so and this side's much closer to the logs. Another objective complete. And my turning circle is terrible and I cannot make that corner. That U-turn. Has to be a 3-point turn. Which still didn't quite work. That's okay. It's only 57 damage total. Not too much more to do. Now one more load of wood, one more load of logs and one more load of pipes. Didn't think so. Now it's a many point turn this time. There we go. All loaded up. Good, didn't go in that little ditch to the left there. I think it was like time last time I went through this bit. I think it was dark. It was night time. So I remember going through the water thinking, I think that's where I need to go straight ahead. And it was. Wish the game had better draw distance. It'd have pretty nice scenery. but they have terrible draw distance, so you can't see the scenery. This is the last time I need to come down here. That is close, but it's okay. We'll stick in first gear here. For this corner at least. This corner is terrible. There we go. Oh, and the next corner, the hairpin. There we go, made it. Now I'll go up a gear. I didn't get any damage there. I think the last time I went in down there in first gear the whole way. Just make sure, yep, loads are all good still. When I get to the bottom of the mountain or the hill, I'm gonna drop down to first. It is the last time I need to go through here, but it'll still be hard if I get stuck. So better to be safe than sorry. I don't really want to be getting the loose rocks because that means the tires are going to be on loose ground and make it easier to spin out and get bogged. The last thing I want to happen. I do have my lights on already. Not sure why I thought that they possibly could have turned off. I already drove at night once, so... I'll try not to go in the same tracks as last time, because last time I was spinning my wheels, so I should be able to see where I was. Where I got stuck. Or maybe not. I think I've just gone past it. But I couldn't see my tracks. That's okay, I didn't get bogged this time though. And that is the main thing. Now I can go faster. Wonder how long this map's taken me. I've only been going for, well, playing the game for under an hour today. I can't remember how long I played it yesterday before. Got the end of the stream. And of course it's getting dark again already. That's okay though. While I'm here I'll prepare and get fuel. There we go. I should have done that last time too. There's that objective complete. So there's that one's complete, that one's complete, and that one's complete. Only got that one to go. Sure what I hit there. All good, no damage to myself. That was easier than last time. Last time I had my foot on the brake and I was in second gear, just using my brake to slow myself down going down. That time I just stuck it in first gear and released everything. No accelerator and no brake, and just glided down in first gear. And that's why they say when going down steep hills, stick in a low gear, you have more control of the vehicle. I've never actually done off-roading and never had that experience, but I've heard it said a few times. And driving in these games, it's pretty realistic to physics, so it makes sense. I'm going to go the same way as I did last time, save myself getting bogged going into the place from this way. Not much point of going up a gear there. good I didn't go off the cliff. Or over the edge. It's raining. You're not actually sitting in the cab, so you don't get it on the window or anything. You're sitting on the roof, doing it Mr. Bean style, when he bought a seat that didn't fit in his car. He tied the seat to his roof, tied ropes to the steering wheel, sat on the seat on top of the car and used the ropes to steer, and had a broom to control the accelerator and brake. There we go. Last load is loaded up. Going a bit faster this time. I'll see if I momentum will get me up here. Close. Come on. Made it up. But now the trailer's stuck on it. Should be able to get it out doing this. There we go, got it. That was a bit easier. Just needed momentum. Yeah, go on the road again. Last time coming through here as well. I am kind of surprised I only rolled twice. Very unlikely I'll roll again, now. If I wanted, there would be another way I can go to deliver this load, but I like crossing the bridge. There is a ramp down to the river right next to the bridge on the right, where I could go there and then go up the ramp that was next to the cloaking that was in the water. Will the truck turn this time? It was close, but made it. I kind of wanted that to break, because I haven't broken it yet. This time the last delivery place is to the left, at the end of the highway this way. Doubt this truck has a fifth gear, a sixth gear. What the? I must not have sixth gear in the menu. No. There we go. That's in the sixth gear spot. It was still in fifth gear. And here we go. And complete. Why does that have to be so bright on white? Well, white text on very bright background. 2 hours, 7 minutes. 271 litres of fuel consumed. Trucks unlocked 3 of 3. Garage unlocked 2 of 2. Cloaking areas removed 13 of 13. Distance travelled 20.74k. Times rescued 1. Yep.